there it is, the Dust Eater. That means we've reached our spot. This place has hardly changed. Well, except for all that miasma. Yeah, Aunt Matilda's old homestead is somewhere in that canyon. Of course, it's covered in miasma now. Who knows what's left? Anyway, Councilman Narrows has given me the honor of overseeing your initiation rites. Normally, he'd be running it, of course, but I've only been back for a week, you know? I wanted to see for myself how much you've improved since I last saw you. So the first rite is to establish a home. After all, you can't be a homesteader without a home. Unfortunately, you'll need to start off with a tent. Not the most sturdy of structures, but, gotta start somewhere. That'll keep the elements out. Probably. Maybe. Don't worry. You'll get the materials to build a proper house before long. Just like your Aunt Matilda did. Now, the second rite demonstrates your botany know-how. You'll need to plant a seedling and then make it grow. We'll start with a Little Rock favorite. Corn.
where are you going? That's the miasma. You don't want to go there. Come back. Hey, where are you going? How's it going? Yeah? What is that? How's it going? What do you want to talk about? Hey, do you remember your first plant? The first one you raised without Ma's help? It was... Now, what was it? Well, it was a flowering plant, that's for sure. You know what? I think you're right. Downright invisible in the snow they were. I remembered you cared for those flowers more than you cared for yourself. Sometimes I'd catch you sneaking out in the middle of the night just to watch them. It seemed to pay off, though. Within a week, they were blooming, in the middle of winter, no less. Really showed the power of tender, loving care right there. Sure, the magic helps, but... What I'm trying to say is, it's good to care. Not enough people in this world care anymore.
right? Now I want to see you cast a watering spell. Should help it grow, at least a little. Of course, channeling is much more effective. You do know how to channel, right? Stop pulling my tail. I've seen you channel before. Channeling is that thing you do where you pull mana from the earth and guide it through the plant, making it instantly grow. You know, channeling. Now stop making me look like a fool and show me you can channel. Imagine if you couldn't channel, huh? Your plants would take forever to grow. Of course, you don't want to overdo it and blight the poor thing. All things in moderation, right? The second rite is complete, and now time for the third. You'll prove yourself as a witch by building a cauldron and then brewing spell potions. Now, I can't just give you a cauldron. That's part of the witching test. But technically, a workbench doesn't have anything to do with being a witch, right?
the nag, but are you sure that's the best place for it? Try moving it to a better spot. Not sure if that's a good spot for it either. No matter. If you change your mind, you can just move it again. Anyway, the cauldron. You'll need wood for the foundation, lavender for purification, and metal for the, well, cauldron. You can get some of those things in the meadow to the north, but that's blocked off. Luckily, I have all the ingredients you need. Very nice. All it needs now is something brewing in there and you'll be a real witch. Which brings me to the third rite, potion making. With what you've currently got, you'd only be able to make a ripple potion. But that's all right. Ripple is plenty useful. Oh, right, you need silver. Before you ask, I do have some on me, but these will be the last of the handouts. People are always losing things, right? And Ripple is great for finding stuff, so this'll be a bestseller for sure. Anywho, you've just completed the initiation rites, so you're now officially a part of the Homestead Arcana program. Congratulations. Your reward lies in... Oh no. You have to understand, the miasma tides are unpredictable. When I hit it a week ago, the border was a good 10 yards away. What I'm saying is, I think your prize is in the miasma. Yeah, it's not good at all. I was hoping it wasn't going to come to this. Well, not so soon, anyway. When you're ready, meet me by the border and listen to my instructions, okay? soon as you walk through that veil, you're gonna be breathing miasma. And you're really gonna feel it in your lungs. That's why it's important that you find the reward as soon as possible. It's in a crate not too far from here, but it might be hard to see it. Drinking a ripple potion will enchant your sight and help you see better. Come on, give it a sip. Big and bright, anything important will light up like I do. Okay, don't stay too long in the miasma. Keep an eye out for a wooden crate. It shouldn't be too far from the entrance. Thanks, son, you're alive. I was starting to get worried. I'm not sure what happened, but I was waiting for you outside the miasma, and then you just showed up like you were washed ashore. All I could do was drag you up to the bed and pray you'd be fine. Oh, it was... well, I wouldn't say it was nothing, but... anyway, this is why you need to be more careful in the miasma. Bring spells, bring snacks, and don't disturb the wildlife.
You okay? Are you dizzy? How's your breath? Your blood pressure? Are you sure? Maybe it's a miasma talking.
The box had blasting powder, right? You should be able to... Over there, we should be able to get you a quick bite to eat.
Crab apple. Give it a bite. Thank you. keep looking around here, by the way. Lots of wood, metal, various herbs and spices. Now, I understand that you might want to explore the miasma some more, but there are other things you can be doing. For example, Abraham should be coming back any time now, and when he does, he'll have useful things to buy. And, oh, I think you have mail. You should always be checking your mail. Yep, always check your mail. And your packages, too. Never know what you'll get. And, make sure to take advantage when Abraham's here so you can sell your produce for silver. Wait, I already said that, didn't I? Look, I know you want to go back into the miasma. Just remember when you're in there that the town still needs you. When you want to go back in there, talk to me. I'll give you a device that'll help you breathe easier. This is a mask for protection. It won't stop the poison from reaching your lungs, but it'll slow it down. Tilly, your Aunt Matilda, found it years ago during one of our expeditions. Again, it's not going to make you invincible, and it definitely won't protect you from the wildlife out there. Anyway, if you're insisting on going out into the miasma, Tilly's old homestead isn't far from here. Maybe you can find her grill. Thank you. You're back. Do you have the grill? Wait. I know what that is. But how has it stayed intact? It's something your aunt and I came up with. A special kind of fertilizer, but not one you'd use in your garden. You might have seen a scar already. There are these huge cavities in the earth that let out all this miasma. But according to the Academy journals, deep inside those scars are dust eaters. But just like the one on your homestead, and they're stunted. So in theory, you pour this fertilizer into the scar, and the dust eater instantly grows full size, soaking up the surrounding miasma. I said, in theory. We didn't know if it was the location, the age of the tree, or what. But it didn't seem to do anything. You're still welcome to try, of course. Just don't get your...